Love Island, Africa, episode 2. So yeah, episode 2 was a little bit better. I mean, like, it wasn't as jarring as episode 1, yeah? But the more I watched it, something just felt off. Something felt uneasy. It kind of felt like I was eating Weet-Bix, but dry. It was super hard to digest. And then it hit me. These guys are actually worse than your common F-boys and F-girls, because at least they give you the bare minimum. Exhibit A. Please, let me know, where is this acceptable? How, Sway? How? They took us to the Grand Canyon to show us how echoes work. They gave us a game to play. Where's Wally? AKA, where is the camera? Here, this comment is facts. They couldn't give us the bare minimum. So because of that, we're fair to rest. I am now resting.
First impressions on Love Island, South Africa. So first up, we got a girl, Erin, you know, pretty nice girl and everything, but that American accent is just so annoying, I'm sorry. So next up, we got a girl, Millie, right? And I'm pretty sure we can all tell that she's super keen for the show. And all I have to ask you, Millie, is, are those real? Your voluptuous Kylie Jenner lips, are they real? Next up, we got a girl, Rochelle, right? And she could be my personal favorite, not only because she's from Pretoria, but I think she's got the right stuff to win the show. Next up, we got a girl, Timna, right? And I think she has a really good chance of winning the show just because she's very mature, honest, and I think the most genuine girl on the show. Next up, we got a girl, Summer, right? And the only thing I have to comment on is her having a Portugal flag in her Instagram bio. She looks more Afrikaans than the girl from bloody Pretoria. And in all her highlight stories, she's never traveled to Portugal, but she's traveled to every other country in the world. Explain yourself. But next up, we got our boy Asad, right, who claims to not be an F-boy, which directly translates that he is an F-boy, so thanks for telling us. So next up, we got my boy Cage, right, who apparently was a tennis coach in the past, but now is unemployed. So my assumption is that he probably got fired because he was teaching high school girls how to grip on other things besides tennis rackets. So next up, we have our boy Jay, right, and we can just tell that his ethnicity is 100% Joburg boot. So next up, we have our boy Ian, right, also from Pretoria, and we can all guess which school he went to, boys, I. And obviously his favorite subject there was Eerste Span Rugby. Next up we have our boy Durang. And honestly, Mnet, I'm just so disappointed. They can't even get a guy that was born in South Africa for a South African television show. Please, just do your job, Mnet.
Do you have plans to do anything? Because I want to go and watch Love Island. There's so much controversy around the whole thing. Harley, do you want to come watch with me?
So now what's happening? Who are these people?
This Durang guy doesn't seem to let anyone talk.
Where's the sound?
And I must go turn it on and off again at the wall.
Still not working.
Guys, is my TV broken? Harley, did you break my TV? But now I can't hear what that guy's saying.
How do these guys keep lifting weights?
But now, Mnet, I've seen this whole part before.
The Donald guy talks a lot, hey? No, Jack, I don't talk a lot. Jack, please can you go and pour me another gin? And now?